Hi, everyone. Now, it's going to be a little bit different today because I felt prompted to take you back to the concert, or take you forward to the concert that took place on the Sea of Galilee. Now, many of you may say, well, Kim, you know what? I watched it already. Let me read something to you. This is from Pat. And she says, just to say again to Kim and team, what a powerful anointed concert from the soil of Israel. Wow, I've watched it 3 times and can't get enough. I was present with the tour in 2011 for that prophetic concert. While it was wonderful, this concert was over the top. Kim is right. This was the most blessed and anointed gathering I've ever been part of, even if only through the computer screen. Thank you, Kim and team, and all who were involved in bringing forth the vision God has given. I'm honored to be a part of your destiny. Okay, that was written by Pat, and there were others that, you know, that wrote in, many of you, and said, you know, I got something out of it when I watched again. So, you know, when I was praying about it, I felt, you know, I should edit it a little bit, bring it, make it shorter, and take you into the concert, the prophetic concert, if you wish, for the first portion, and then you could join me as I share some special thoughts after we were prophesying, you will live. And then I tell everybody, and this is what I want you to take note of. This is not just a concert like you'd go to Barbara Streisand or something like that where you all just sing and you go home. This is where we actually hear the Spirit of the Lord telling us, instructing us. And one of the things he said was to prophesy to anything dead in your life. Now, I'm going to take you there now. Watch the first section. When we get there, I'm going to come back to you here on the den at the Matrix and share with you a few things and give you an opportunity to support Israel, to support what we're doing. It's very important, but as I've taught you before, when God speaks and when God is present, that's when you sow, that's when you ask, that's when you proclaim, that's when you pray. And so that's what I want us to do together. So this is going to be a little more personable. So here we go. Let's go into the concert now, right from the beginning. And when we get to the part where you literally see me instructing the people to prophesy over their families or whatever, do it with them, and then I'll be back with you. Let's go. Thank you.
gentlemen, 3,000 years ago, King David reigned over the Jewish state in our eternal capital, Jerusalem. I say that to all those who proclaim that the Jewish state has no roots in our region and that it will soon disappear. Throughout our history, the Jewish people have overcome all the tyrants who have sought our destruction. It's their ideologies that have been discarded by history. The people of Israel live on. We say in Hebrew, Am Yisrael Chai. And the Jewish state will live forever.
Israel. Prophesy. You will live. You will live. You will live. Israel. 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 We prophesy. You will live.
prophesy with us. Israel, fire, I prophesy. Do it with me today. You will live.
Wow. You know, when I was prophesying and getting the people all over the world, in fact, there were millions of people watching, telling them you need to prophesy to the dead bones, to your family, whatever the situation was, there's death. You know, you've got to understand that when I first planned this concert or prophetic gathering, we had the word attitude. And of course, you know, attitude can be bad or good. In all the stories in the Bible where there's been a victory, there's always been a good attitude. And the attitude could have been defiance against the enemy. And most of the time it was. In Gideon's case, it was almost a little bit of anger, saying to God, "We are the miracles of our forefathers. What happened to the promise?" And yet an angel came to him and said, "I've come to bring you life. You're going to be free from all this debt problem that you've had and all the oppression of the Midianites. It's all come to an end by my promise." And Gideon does something interesting, and I know you've heard me saying this, but I want to give you the opportunity now, because many of you sang with all of us and began to prophesy over the dead bones, the prognosis in your life. And you know, when God is present, that's the time to give. And so I want to give you that moment, because now is the time. Let's do it. Let's look at what Gideon did. You know, I love the fact that the angel brought a promise to him. You, the one chosen to bring an end to this oppression. You watching me now saying, "You know, Kim, I want the end of my oppression." But you have a promise already. The promise was right there. You just heard it. It was given from Israel to you, to your homes. And so what you want to do now is you want to respond, because that's what worship is. A lot of people don't realize what worship is. They think it's just lifting their hands and worshiping and singing, and it's all part of it. But worship is the response to the revelation of God. Now, let me share why that is. In worship, there's always a revelation. God always reveals himself, his presence, or his word, or his promise. Now, a revelation is not enough. Response to a revelation is an act of worship. In other words, how you respond determines the measure of your blessing. So in other words, if God says to you, I'm going to bless you, I'm going to give you a business, or I'm going to help you financially, I'm going to help you and your family, whatever, how you respond determines the measure of that blessing. You can get the blessing by responding and saying, yes, I believe it. Or you can do what Gideon did and Abraham did and many of them did, where he went and said to the angel, stay here, I'm going to get an offering because I want to sow into this promise so it'll come to pass. I want a huge blessing. Gideon is in the history books today. It went down in history because of what he did. He took 300 men and overcame tens of thousands of oppressors. In other words, you want to do something monumental. So what I want to ask you today to do is this. You have a revelation. God said, if you prophesy of your dead bones, of your problems, of your curses, I'm going to bring them to life. In other words, I'm going to bring back something greater than the curse. I'm going to bring a blessing. How you respond determines the outcome or the measure of your blessing. If you respond big, you get a big measure. Now, for some of you, big may be $15. But do something. Don't sit there and say, well, I just want to hear the rest of the concert. No, you want to sow into a promise that just came. Dead bones come back to life. In other words, God wants total restoration in your family. So let's do it. Let's do what Gideon did and said, wait here. I want to go and get an offering. We're waiting. The concert's waiting. Everything's waiting because we want to sow and then go back into it and enjoy what God says to the rest of the world. But this is for you personally now. Let's pray. Father, I ask you in the name of Yeshua, your son, to speak to every person, to make them realize that worship is not complete until there is a response to the revelation. I pray that as each person responds to the revelation that has come regarding dead bones coming back to life, curses being reversed into blessings, that you would speak to each warrior and show them what to give. They're sowing to Israel. They're sowing to the promise. They're sowing to their families and their futures. Speak to everyone now and show them what to give. Wait here, angel. I've got the word, but I want to respond to the revelation so this could be an act of worship. And I thank you, Lord, for speaking to each heart. Now, each one of you, all you have to do is stop for a minute and say, I'm going to sow. So that I may increase the measure of my blessing when it comes. Now, Lord, as they respond, I pray you'd watch and you'd bring to life that which they thought was dead. And I thank you for it. Amen. Now, I want you to do is, you see the red link below your screen, go there now and give your special offering. Now, some of you may be saying, you know, I gave on Saturday. Why should I do it again? You don't have to. But it's part of our life. It's our worship. You know, one thing I like about the prophetic word is when God speaks, it's fresh, it's now, and it's for your benefit. The only response he wants from you, or responses, is yes. Faith says yes, I believe it. Now I want to act. I'm going to respond with an offering. That's worship. When Abraham went to sacrifice, you can give while I'm talking to you. While Abraham went to sacrifice his son, God's request, he told his servants when he was about to climb Mount Moriah, he said to them, wait here, my son and I are going yonder to worship. In other words, he counted his response as an act of worship, and God always blesses worship, always. And so once you're responding now, Abraham responded, laid his son on the altar. You know the story, but it doesn't end there. I love how it ends, actually. He doesn't speak about Abraham now. He says, stop, I see that you would not withhold what I asked you to give me. And because you did not withhold, I will bless your children. They will possess the gates of their enemies because you committed this act of worship. God considered the response worship. God reveals himself and you do nothing, it's not considered worship. And I'm not just talking about money. I'm talking about in heart, in praise, in response, in faith. Now continue giving. If you want to text, you can do it as well. It's so simple. While you're sitting there, just text to 43965 and say, I vote for Kim. the American Idol. Okay, all you got to do is put 43965, gift, and your amount, $10, $15, $20, whatever you feel like giving, $100, $1 million, we can use it. We're building a house, plus I've made a commitment to the Wolfson Medical Center to give them $2 million. Yes, I know I'm crazy. I've lost my mind, and I'm not missing it at all. So I want you to know something. I'm not thinking. I'm thinking by faith. God says Kim and his warriors are going to build an extension. What is it called? It's called the hybrid operating room to help young children. And my warriors are going to give $2 million. We don't have it. We don't have 1 cent towards it. But we're going to do it. And you know what's going to happen? God's going to build our church. Our church. Cash. We're not going to go to the bank. Come on, how's that for a statement? In fact, I'm going to sow into it. So there you go. While you're giving, just remember to say to God, here I am doing, I'm responding to your revelation. Now you can continue doing it while we go back. I don't want to keep you because we need to go back in to this powerful prophetic concert. Now you're going to see some fantastic stuff right now. You're going to see some Israeli musicians. You're going to hear Hannah singing. Hannah is going to sing in different languages. You're going to be so blessed. And then you're going to have the maestro sit at his piano with arms that were broken. And they said, I would never be able to play what I played that day. You're going to see me play and defy with an attitude. I'm going to play this piano when I was told I couldn't do it. You will never, those surgeons said to me in 1993, 94, when I had the surgery, they said, you will never play the piano like you did before classically. It takes a special type of wrist coordination to play a classical piece. And I played that piece, and my team watched and laughed at me because there were a few little mistakes. And it's always good to be imperfect, isn't it, Charlie? I made a few mistakes, but you know what? I got through my little Flight of the Bumblebee in classics piece. You'll see that, and then you'll hear us going into Israel is forever, and you watch how they respond. And while they do that, I want you to do it as well. I want you to shout out, Israel is forever, because it is! Because that's the promise that he gave. Okay, while you're giving and praying and worshiping, let's go back.
Yeah. is late. You can dance if you want, even though it's hot. You can lift your hands up. Come on. try to break my hands, and God anointed them and healed them. existence of the kingdom of God. And the Spirit of the Lord says, let me hear your voices from this land, and I will return, and I will bring blessing upon blessing, says the Lord. Shout! You are favored.
Israel, you are favored.
Sing it again.
Israel, you are favored.
You are radiant.
Israel, you are radiant. Israel, you are radiant.
Prosperous. Say it.
Israel, you are prosperous.
Prophesy with me again.
Israel, you are prosperous.
Victorious.
Israel, you are victorious.
A treasure.
Israel, you are treasure.
You believe in the doings of, wave them on the Sea of Galilee. But again you sing, hallelujah. From the Sea of Galilee, I want to hear you say with me, hallelujah. Say it, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Throw your hands. TV and our warriors that are watching, we got people on the Sea of Galilee right now praising him. This is Jesus' lake. This is his lake. Yeah, come on. Declaration to make with Israel.
You will have protection, supernatural intervention from the Lord Most High.
Where?
From the Lord Most
High.
You will have protection, supernatural intervention from the Lord Most High.
Yeah. Where?
From the Lord
Most High.
Everyone in the house, I want you to just wave your hands like this. I want to acknowledge Yahweh, our Father who is in heaven, whose name is holy, whose name is sacred. Everybody say this with me.
The Lord Most High.
Say it.
Worship you
from the Lord Most High. Everyone sing it with him. Lord.
The Lord.
Singing it so well.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
One more time, everybody. So I met somebody, and he said to me, why don't you come to my home? I didn't know anything about their traditions or their meals, but I was warmly invited and embraced by this family. Excuse me.
that's what he started doing. He's at home on Shabbat. So I said, come here with your table and do it for us, because he did this in the military when he was in the war. My South African friends. I felt like perhaps we should sing just a portion of the South African national anthem. Want to sing it, Brandon?
Oh yeah, come on, here we go! In Kosi Sikelela.
From many different nations, and we want you to put your nation, that name, in there. Tell them how to say that one piece in Kosi Sikaleli.
In Kosi Sikaleli. And then we're gonna have you shout out your nation that's represented here tonight. Okay, let's start with Africa. Here we go. Kosi Sikaleli, Africa. Sing it again to Africa. Come on. In Kosi Sikaleli.
It means God bless Israel.
In Kosi Sikaleli, Israel.
Hey, what about Australia? Ooh, yeah.
In Kosi Sikaleli, Australia.
Now, everybody in this place, shout your nation out now. Shout your nation out now. Guys, you gonna do something for us? All the way from Israel. Welcome them, please. Israel.
Israel, in the future, you look much better than you look right now.
Israel.
Turn around, tell somebody, in your future, you look a lot better than you look right now. Come on, tell someone.
Moses
rock the rock. He did it with an attitude. Go, girls.
Come on.
Fight with an attitude. With an attitude. Do it with an attitude. Gotta walk with an attitude. Live with an attitude. Do it with an attitude.
He called a minstrel with an attitude. Is there a minstrel with an attitude? Elisha needed a minstrel so he could prophesy. Where is the minstrel with an attitude?
Take the spoil, says the Lord.
Come on.
on Israel and America and certain nations that have been weak, and Russia shall be brought to shame, for I shall pull her pants down and reveal her nakedness and her weakness, says the Lord. But today in Israel, here is the good news, says the Spirit of God. I will bring youth, young people from the Middle Eastern nations, and they will join hands, and there shall be a covenant made between the youth of Syria and the youth of Israel. And I shall raise up and put my Spirit upon them, and they shall break the curse that has existed between certain of these nations. I have raised up sheep in wolf's clothing, and I will pay them back for what they have done to Israel. Everybody in this house, say it together. Israel is forever. Say it. Israel is forever. Say it again.
Israel is forever.
Shout it out.
Israel is forever.
Do it again. Do it again. Raise up your mantles. Raise up those mantles that you have in your hand. For the generation that is upon us, God said, I will cause them to prophesy. Your children shall bring the light into the nations. When the warriors raise their mantles, they do it with an attitude. Come on. Now, Lord, as they raise their mantles, I pray for your blessing to come upon each household all over the world, that you would release upon this generation life, light, salvation, joy, prosperity upon each nation represented tonight in the name of the Lord God. Give them a shout. Israel, Israel, I gathered you under my wing. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, I came to you with my light. Came to you with my light. No, I gathered you under my wings. have I forgotten you, Jerusalem? Have I forgotten you, Jerusalem? Have I watched you till this day, Israel? My love, my light, have I forgotten you, Israel? Have I forgotten you, Israel? Once again, I will gather you under my wings. Thank you for your beautiful word, my Lord. Let's thank him for that promise. My tongue be silent, cold, and still. This bounding heart forget to beat. If I forget, your mercy seat. I'll not forget your mercy seat. But he sings with me. I'll not forget your mercy seat. I'll not forget your mercy seat. All over the world right now. Sing. I'll not forget your mercy seat. I'll not forget your sacrifice. My voice, please. I'll not forget your sacrifice. Saving grace. Everybody sing it. I'll not forget your saving grace. Pain and tears. I'll not forget your pain and tears. Your endless love. Sing it, everybody. I'll not forget your endless love.
Just for you.
gave my blood on the cross just for you.
Just for you.
sing with me. That beautiful song. Special needs. God's heart is for them. I want to pay homage and honor to the Shalva. Shalva is a beautiful place that houses special needs children. The most amazing thing that I've ever seen. Changed my heart. We adopted 4 special needs children. And it's the heart of God. I want you to listen to this as she sings this. Not yet. In a minute. Thank you.
להשתוקק להרגיש את פעימות הלב שלך. אני שלך לעולמים.
Close your eyes. Close your eyes. Close your eyes. Watching all over the world. Global. Community of people. Trust you can hear me. From this beautiful land of Israel. I pray the reward and the blessing of the Lord upon your house. You know, I would be dead today was it not for Israel giving to me my Savior. I've been asked so many times, why do you love Israel? There are many reasons. But in an old street, I lay and I called out to the one that I thought might be able to help me. Jesus. And it was because of this land that I received my Savior. I want you to think about this just for a minute. A young man whose father is a carpenter grows up working in his father's shop. One day he puts down his tools, he walks out of his father's shop. He starts preaching on street corners and in the nearby countryside. From place to place, he preaches all over. And although he's not an ordained minister, he does this for 3 years. Then he's arrested, he's tried, and he's convicted. And there is no court of appeal. So he's executed at the age of 33, along with two common thieves. Those in charge of his execution roll dice to see who gets his clothing. The only possessions he has. His family cannot afford a burial place for him, so he's interred in a borrowed tomb. End of story? No. This uneducated, propertyless young man has, for 2,000 years, had a great effect on the world. Then all the rulers, the kings and the emperors, all the conquerors, the generals and admirals, all the scholars and the scientists and philosophers who have ever lived, all of them put together, he has had more of effect on humanity. How do we explain that unless he really was what he said he was? And Jesus, we want to thank you from your lake. tonight for your salvation. Let's give him a hand, please.
You know what I love about the prophetic is you get so close to the heart of God. You hear His mind, His thoughts, what He plans to do. You know, you need this on a regular basis. And there are millions of viewers all over the world that experience this twice a week, sometimes even more, at my den. And you can experience it as well. I would love to have you there. All you got to do is go to kim.tv. We have so much. We have worship. We have songs that come from the heart of God, prophetic words about things that have not happened yet. That's why we say to the people, welcome to the future. And I want you to experience that. I look forward to seeing you there.